This pile of snow you see behind me is likely the last I'm going to see here in Ohio this season. And this winter brought me around 6 opportunities to try out my very first snowblower, specifically this Toro 252cc two-stage gas snowblower and the Ego 56-volt two-stage electric snowblower. And today, I'm gonna tell you how these $1,300 monsters tackled my 450-foot driveway. Let's go. At first glance, these both look like giant oversized snow-tossing beasts, and quite frankly, they are. But while the price is identical, the details are not. They're both two-stage, meaning they have a second auger specifically for launching the snow into your neighbor's yard. They're both self-propelled with both forward and back modes, and both have bright LEDs for those dark snowy days. And their metal augers seem up for just about anything. But the devil is in the details. Let's start with the clearing width. The Ego is 24 inches while the Toro is 28. That doesn't sound like a lot, but the results mean I take 3 trips all the way down my driveway and back with the Ego, but the Toro does it in only 2. When you're clearing 450 feet of driveway in 5-degree weather, that extra trip's kind of brutal. And of course, one of these monsters requires gas, oil, maintenance, and leaves you smelling a bit like the fumes it emits. Now, that's clearly not gonna bother some of you. I know Sarah is obsessed with the smell, but it's still there. It's also far noisier than the Ego. That doesn't mean much out here in the country, but my wife mentioned it the first time I used the Ego. She said that she hears the Toro the whole time I'm using it, but never noticed the Ego once. Now, both of these snow blowers throw the snow far. Ego claims 50 feet and Toro says 45, but there's so many different variables that can affect that number. The reality is, at more than one point, I had a driveway covered in very heavy, slushy snow, and neither one of these guys had any problem sending it far off into the woods. Now, of course, with the Toro running on gas, it means that you have to start it up. I use the pole start every time, never had a problem once. But just in case, it's got this clever electric starter built in. All you gotta do is grab an extension cord in your garage, plug it in, hit a button, and you're up and running. But of course, with gas, I'm going to clear my huge driveway several times before I need to gas it up again, and that's simply not true for the Ego. So the Ego just feels easier to take out and use, because it is. You grab 2 batteries, I would grab 2 of our 10 amp hour batteries that came with our Z6 mower, drop them in, and off you go. No fuss, no muss. It just works. And the 2 10 amp hour batteries were able to clear my entire driveway coming in and about half of my roundabout. But of course, your mileage will vary based on the snow you're slinging. I did that much when my drive was covered in almost 6 inches of slushy snow. Now, I read online that other Ego users were having runtime problems, but that's when I learned the best kept secret about the Ego snowblowers. Lower the throttle. It's fun to send the snow 50 feet into the woods, but if it's not necessary, you can throttle it way back and get way more runtime out of it. Now with gas, it's easy to always push the auger to its limit and, you know, blow the snow all over the place. But a more measured hand on the Ego goes a very long way. The other difference is with the auger system. The Ego uses a shear pin. It's a small metal pin that goes through the auger and the shaft that drives it. And when you hit something too hard, like I did when I hit a brick, the pin actually breaks instead of your auger. Now, I know all you snowblower veterans know about this already, but being a new guy, I did not. So once that happened, I searched online, found an obscure hardware store that actually had a pack of Ego pins, and waited almost 2 weeks for them to arrive, only to realize that Ego puts 2 extra pins right here on top. Now the Toro got rid of the shear pin system altogether, replacing them with a hardened gear and a commercial grade gearbox that can sense hard objects and safely stop it. At that point, you just back up, speed the auger back up, and go on. Super nice feature. Now, I didn't have any problems with either one of these guys besides my shear pin replacement. So I went to their websites to read all the reviews that were posted by customers. Both websites were absolutely flooded with great reviews, and all the negative ones tended to be about the same thing. Like the Ego as an example. It was, first of all, the runtime, which I addressed, lower that throttle, and the chute tends to kind of float around. And to fix that, Ego's offered a free upgrade kit that, well, fixes it. They sent me one without even asking. You may need to hit them up for one. The Toro had more than a few complaints about this thing. That's the drive link, which has a tendency to break. I have that one and mine's fine so far, but to fix the problem, they offered a heavy duty replacement for about $3, which I'm gonna go ahead and pick up just as a preventative measure. So after using both of these snowblowers for a full season, what do I think? Well, first you need to understand something. These are the only two snowblowers I've ever used, so keep that in mind. When it comes to power here in Ohio with my extra long driveway, I never once ran into any snow that pushed either one of these models to their limits. The deepest snow I had was only 6 inches, whereas the Ego can handle up to 20 and the Toro 21. I did, however, get to try them both on soft snow and heavy snow. On soft, neither snowblower felt like it was working at all. It just went. But on the heavy slushy stuff, they both clearly were working harder, but never struggled once. They both threw the snow way further than I needed them to, even when the bitter wind forced me to blow it all the way over our roundabout. Now the Toro, being a slightly bigger tool, felt bigger. It was a bit more difficult to maneuver, and I got nervous driving it between our vehicles sometimes, wondering if it was gonna like jump from side to side and leave a mark. While the Ego, on the other hand, just feels more manageable. If you've used both gas and electric chainsaws, you know what I'm talking about. Gas is powerful. It feels more volatile in your hands. It's loud, it vibrates, spits fumes, and feels just barely under your control. But battery-powered tools are on when you hit the button and off when you turn it off. The Ego felt way easier to control and was just less intimidating. My wife wanted to help clear our driveway at one point, and I immediately suggested she grab the Ego. It's powerful enough to do the job, but it's also just easier. You also can't ignore the ultra quiet nature of the thing. If you have neighbors, you could come out and clear your driveway and win some points by clearing theirs, and they'd never know you were even there. Plus, you don't have to store gas in your garage, and it's easier to store a battery powered tool in someplace like an attic, or toss it in the back of your minivan and go help someone across town. But I don't live in a neighborhood like that. I have a huge winding driveway through the woods, and one of these can do it in only 2 trips instead of 3. Look, you guys know me. I love battery powered tools. They're powerful, easy, and clean. Because of that, I want the Ego. But with this property, I need the Toro. The one you want and the one you need might be one and the same, depending on the size of your drive, the proximity of your neighbors, and of course, your climate. I feel real bad for Rob Robillard all the way up there in Massachusetts sometimes. Now this review was not sponsored by either Ego or Toro, but they did both send us these test units to try out and we greatly appreciate it. Last of all, it's March. Depending on how far north you live, you might be done with snow too for the season, but that makes this the best time to buy a snowblower. As of today, Home Depot has the Toro available for only $11.99, and Lowe's doesn't have this guy on sale just yet, but they do have the 21-inch single stage one for only $5.49. So, if you want to save a few bucks, now's the time to do it. Thanks for hanging out with me today, guys. If you have a favorite snowblower you want to tell me all about, please do in the comments below and I'll be sure to respond. And don't forget to join us this and every Friday for our Power Tool Week in Review. I'll see you then. What is he doing? Throw something at him. Connor, our squirrel, our albino squirrel is, I don't know, humping a limb. I don't know what he's doing up there, but he's going, and I don't know if you can hear it or not. Olaf, get down.